Marketing communication strategy is a significant tool for guiding the interactions with consumers. Planning is important for ensuring success in achieving your communication goals. I'm Catherine Ngahu from SBO Research, where we do market research services. Thank you for tuning into my channel, Elevators, where we share elevating and empowering information to help raise our standards in life, career, and business. In this video, I will talk about the process to follow in developing a marketing communication strategy. This information is useful for business people, marketers, those working in marketing, as well as students of business and communications. A marketing strategy is a roadmap that guides on how communication will be used to meet specific marketing objectives. It helps to inform, sensitize, and persuade your customers in a structured manner. A clear marketing communication strategy details how information will flow to achieve the intended marketing objectives, how the right message will get to the right people at the right time and in the right manner. A marketing communication strategy is essential for the same reason a football team needs a defense layout. A communication strategy guides you so that you stay focused on your target audience and objective. It guides on message development and selection of the delivery channels. It helps assess message understanding by the target audience. A good communication strategy provides clarity and simplifies the work of message development. It helps create messages that are relevant and motivating to the target audience. A good communication strategy can improve interaction and help you receive information and feedback from your audience. Now, let's go to the six M's of developing marketing communication strategy. I use the M to simplify and make it easy to remember the six steps. Do stay with me to the end of this video so you can have the full benefit of what I've prepared for you. In any case, you need to reach to the sixth M as a minimum. Now, to the six M's of developing marketing strategy. The first M is for mission. This represents the purpose of your communication. What is the objective of your marketing communication? What exactly do you want to achieve? You need to clarify your agenda. The reason for starting with your mission is that it helps you to recognize who to direct your communication to. It helps you to stay focused on agenda. Common marketing communication objectives include to inform, you know, create awareness. We are always talking about creating awareness, to persuade consumers, or to even get people to change their behavior or attitudes. It could be to inform about your product, what it does, its benefits, what it's for, and who it's for. The mission could be to increase sales or usage, or to attract them to a certain outlet or online platform. Another mission or purpose could be to persuade them to buy a product or change the how, when, how frequently they use a certain product. For example, I've seen advertisement in the past by Scott Emulsh, who used to say something like a spoonful of health every day, basically emphasizing daily usage. That was a communication emphasizing daily usage. Marketing communication objectives should be SMART. SMART as in S for specific and clear, M for measurable, A for attainable, R for realistic, and T for time bound. The second M is, for the lack of a better word, male or female. It's a question. Basically, it's about identifying your exact target audience, the people who you want to communicate with. You need to clearly define the people who you want to target with your communication. Who do you want to reach with your message? Refer back to your mission in order to clarify your objective, because once your purpose is clear, it becomes easier to identify who to direct your communication to. In many cases, the target of marketing communication could be customers or your sales team. It could also be distributors or retailers or other stakeholders who you need to speak to. So you need to be very specific. In each case, you need to clarify the defining factors, the demographics and other factors of this target group. The information about your target, particularly their gender, their age group, social status, income, location, and the like. The more you know about your target audience, the easier it will be to develop an effective message. Some companies gather lifestyle and personality data to help understand their target audience better. And this makes it easier to communicate with the target audience because you tend to develop messages that are very focused, that really generate interest, and which really speak to that group. It also depends if your communication is for consumers, that is B2C, or for business clients, B2B. The third M is for message. You need to develop a compelling message. The message is the idea or information that you want to convey to your target audience. You need to decide the exact message that you want to pass. And you need to decide how to say it in a way that is compelling to the target audience while addressing the intended marketing communication objective. To create a powerful message, you need to consider the first two M's, that is the mission and the people that you want to communicate with. Because this is how you create a message that is fitting with the target audience. And again, the message should be able to appeal to the target people and be focused on the objective. To succeed in getting people to behave in a specific way or to take a particular action, then the type of message you use should be engaging, interesting, aligned to what matters to the target group, and it should be expressed in a compelling way. To be persuasive and compelling, a message needs to follow the principles of the AIDA model. This is called the AIDA model. That is A for attention, I for interest, D for desire, and A for action. This works in developing marketing messages where the intention is to persuade, to motivate, and to influence people to act in a certain way. The fourth M is for media. You need to select the media or channels of communication that you will use. Again, this depends on the first three steps. So you look at the audience, that is the men and women, you look at the mission, and you look at the message, the first three M's. Then depending on the target audience and the purpose, you could then decide to use face-to-face communication or electronic media or social media platforms or even broadcast media as appropriate. You could also have a meeting either face-to-face or online using Zoom or other meeting platforms. Now, when selecting the channels, you consider what you want in terms of reach and frequency, message focus and target group, as well as cost effectiveness. Each channel has different strengths and weaknesses. And so it's important that you use multiple channels in order to reinforce the message and ensure that you are able to reach your target audience. The modes of delivery are many. Advertising is one of the most common methods that is used for delivering messages to consumers. And the common channels include print media, television, exhibitions, roadshows, internet, websites, social media, and the like. Some people still use mail, email, radio, and so on, depending on the intention, the target group, and the message. The fifth M is for money. We cannot forget to talk about money, because marketing communication costs money. Therefore, you need to plan a budget for it. There are several ways to determine the budget for marketing communication. And you could consider the objective and cost method, where you seek to achieve an objective and apply the cost that will be relevant for achieving that objective. Another way is to look at the value of the sales targeted and then take a percent of that. There are also companies that use the previous budget for marketing communication in the previous year and then add a small percent, like say 5%, for the following year. The sixth M is for measurement. You have to evaluate your communication. It's important to decide how you will assess the effectiveness of communication early on. Evaluation is important in marketing communication as it helps you to determine the success of the message conveyed in achieving the objective of marketing communication. That is what was your intention in the very first place. Feedback is crucial in helping you understand if your message was understood and accepted by the target audience. Furthermore, it helps you to know the extent to which your communication objectives were met. To assess communication effectiveness, you can use a survey with the target audience or assess goal achievement, such as sales and the like. And depending on the objective, maybe you could even use data analytics if it was an online communication. To sum up, the six M's in developing marketing communication strategy are: one, mission or objectives. Second, male or female, that is for target audience. Third is message. Fourth is media or channels. Fifth is money or budget. And sixth is measurement or evaluation of the communication. There you have it, the simplest way to remember the six important steps to follow in developing marketing communication strategy that works. Using the six M's approach will help you improve your marketing communication planning and give you an advantage in the marketplace. Again, making it 6M, I'm sure will make it simple and easy to remember because six are too many. That's why I use the M's, because it makes it very easy for all of us to remember. So do share this video with someone who you think might benefit from it. It could be someone in business, or one working in a marketing department of a company, or a student of marketing or business communications. Thank you and best wishes. Keep watching. We all need to elevate our mindsets at this time.